You go down there with the rest of us, you want to back up staff or cast there.
Okay, now we need one plant. Well, I need another plant. Can you go get another plant? Go find another plant for me. Pick out anybody. Pick out somebody that doesn't look like they want to do it. Okay, I need two thorns. Can somebody go get me two thorns? You go get me one thorn and you go get me another thorn. Will you please? Somebody looks thorny this morning. You find him, will you please? Now I need somebody who's going to be a good friend. I need someone. You already found someone. You found someone. Who can, BG, can you find somebody who looks like they'd be a good plant? Can you do that? Now let me see if I got my staff figured out here. I got a sower. Who's the sower? Okay. I need two quick plants. Who are the quick plants? Josh, you're not going to join us here? Oh, okay. We need a new quick plant. Can you find a quick plant for me? You don't want to find somebody? You find somebody for it, okay? Okay. I need two birds. Two of a bird. Okay. I need another good plant. Who is that you look for? Two thorns. Two of my thorny people. And one good plant. That's you. And that you must be the other quick plant. Okay. We're going to read the scripture of the parable of the sower. And to help you understand the parable of the sower, we're going to have our cast of actors here, the Not Ready for Prime Time cast, to do our play. Now, we need to take our places. If you'll come over here. Now, you are the sower of the good seed. Now, you have to understand here that sowing in the Bible time, we had a big sack of seed here. And we toss the seed. Now, we don't plow the seed, okay? Toss the seed around, nonetheless. Plow us in your long little joy, because we're passing out the good seed, okay? If you'll take your place over by the table. Now, I need the two birds. Where are my birds? Birds, thank you. Come here. Now, she's going to pass out some seeds, and you know what happens to the first seed. It's on the hard soil. Okay, now we need birds who, yeah, obviously you know what birds do, right? That's good. Now, I understand this is important for our young people. And so if we don't do it well, we'll do it again, okay? Now, I also understand we're not just flying. We're all getting seats. Okay, so you got to get the seat to it. He'll stand right about down there for me, please. Okay, now I need two quick plants. Where are my quick plants? Come on now. You don't need to be right here to my right, if you will. I'll scoot over just a little. You'll stand right here. Now, what you're going to do, quick plants, is you'll come down just like this. And on the key word, oh, now you can handle this. You don't have to stay down here. I'll let you out until you're full of the key here. And then you need to spring up and be a quick plant. But you understand the sun comes up. And then you got to wither down. Now, the quick part is easy, but the withering, it takes a lot of skill. One needs to wither with intensity. Okay? Can we feel the fart? Can we feel the fart? We're counting on you. We're counting on you. Now I need the second good plant, or the third good plant here. Is that you, Trevor? MSC. Okay, you need to come here. Oops. I'm going to turn the church off. Someone accused me of that. Okay, you need to be here. You need to do the same thing. You need to kneel, and when it's time to spring forth, to come forth, and look real good. Now, who are my thorns? Okay. We need a thorn on the left and a thorn on the right. Okay, you'll need your hands free for this. Yes. Okay, you know what thorns do to a good plant? We jolt. So you need to choke the good plant, if you will. Well, thank you.
Unless you'd like to practice.
Would you like to?
Okay. And now Donnie, here's a good plant, one of theirs approved.
Okay, so you need to spring forward, lovely and beautiful.
And look as if you're very true, would you please?
Okay.
Are there any questions about our roles here?
Do we all understand what we need to do?
Now, what we want you to do, Deb, is we want you to come clear across here and scatter the seed from one table to the other, if you would. Then birds, if you would, you need to fly across here and pick up as much of the seed as you can as you go through.
Okay.
Now, the rest of you, you'll need to stay in your positions. Okay. It's important for us that you be there. And birds, it is important for us that you return. Because we'll have to explain the parable. Okay? Okay, now I'm going to read the parable, and you guys act on cue, if you will. The Sabbath was made for man, so we were okay. Now I need to get out of the road here. Does this look bad? Tough. Okay, on cue now. On the same day that Jesus went out of the house, he sat by the lake. There was such a large crowd gathered around him that he got into a boat and he sat in it while all the people stood on the shore. Then he told them many things in a parable, saying, now listen. A farmer went out to sow his seed. A little more about it. I've only got a half an hour. Very fine. You can tell she was born on a track. As he stared at the seed, some fell on the path. And the birds came and ate it up. You need to get the seed down. There you go. You're not doing a very good job getting it. You're going to starve. Some fell in rocky places where it did not have much soil. It sprang up quickly. Close enough. But because the soil was shallow, when the same sun came up, the plants were scorched and they withered because they had no roots. Other seed fell among the thorns, which grew up. And the thorns choked the plant. Try again. Thank you. Still other seed fell on good soil where it produced a crop 100, 60, or 30 times what was sown. We can cut that one down, don't we? Okay. He who has ears to hear, let him hear. Now, I can tell you what Jesus said to Pharaoh meant. When anyone hears the message about the kingdom and does not understand it, the evil one comes and snatches away that which was sown. The birds down there, who are flying and picking up the grain, they are the ones who are snatching it away from us, the evil one. The truth that was sown by death is the truth of God, the gospel of Jesus Christ, the thing that teaches right and wrong. The evil one, if we don't allow it to grow into our hearts, will snatch it away. The one who received the seed that fell on rocky places is the man who hears the word at once and receives it with joy. See how he sprang up? But since he has no roots, he lasts only a short time. When trouble or persecution comes because of the word, he quickly falls away. The one who received the seed
That fell among the thorns is the one who hears the word, but the worries of his life and the deceitfulness of wealth choke it, making it unfruitful. But the one who received the seed that fell on good soil is the man who hears the word and understands it. He produces a crop yielding 100, 60, or 30 times that which was sown. Those who have ears to hear, let them hear. Thank you, Cass, for helping us. Now, let's talk about the parable of your life. What does that mean? And what does that mean to you guys down here? And what does that mean to all of us? One of the things that means is that it teaches us that we're all dirt. We're all dirt. Some of us are good dirt. Some of us are not so good dirt. What are you, fellas? Are you good dirt or bad dirt? Those who are of good dirt allow the truth, the gospel of Jesus Christ, to go real far deep into their hearts. And what do? They bear all good fruit. Some of us don't listen very well, and so we don't understand. So when the truth of God comes into our lives, the birds eat it away. Some of us, we listen, but we don't allow it to get down deep where it makes sense to us. And so we spring up and think, this is great, and then we fall away when trouble or problems come our way. And some of us allow the gospel to come into our lives and teach us and bring us truth. Well, but if things get rough, sometimes we decide to go in other directions. We seek for money or positions or power. Then we get choked by the pleasures of the world. Each of us should want to be good people. Each of us should allow the gospel to come into our lives that it might bear fruit. What kind of soil are you kids today? I hope you're good soil. I hope you kids are good soil. I hope all of us are the soil that Jesus needs. Let's pray and may God help us. Father, we're so very grateful that the gospel of Jesus Christ roots deeply into the lives and helps the life to grow, to bear fruit. Oh, how we need your help, Father, though, to be the good soil. To allow the soil to open itself up to the truth. Help each one of these boys and girls, each one of these moms and dads and people around us, open our hearts for the truth. And may you bless us with the peace of the Word of God. Well, I'm going to thank you for helping me with our children, sir. Thank you very thank you.
Tyler.
Man, no idea. I smashed them, then I didn't get burned.
You were a good boy, weren't you?
Get up and walk, you little poop, you. Yeah.
Right, called me a little poop. Come get it.
Tyler. Hi there, buddy.
No.
Thank you.
Not you, huh? Okay.
Don't you want your picture taken? You got a chocolate
mouth.
What did you eat?
Hi, bud.
Ice cream.
Might not even been doing anything then.
why I've never heard it click.
Hey, Ty Bud.
I told you it's so dark under there, you probably won't get him.
Ty Bud. Hey. There he goes. He's going for the basket.
No. That's who they say looks like Chris. Who was that? Take two of these. Tyler, where's your pinky? Where's your pinky?
I don't know if it's moving much or not. Hey. We're talking Bigfoot here. This is Bigfoot Enterprises here.
How'd it look when it came out this time?
It was pretty good.
Was it as neat as yours?
I'd say it probably was. Smile for the camera, lady, please. Hey, you with the shovel in your hand.
Definitely put a wrinkle in the tail.
Aftermath of the tree. Try it. Gonna have to yank it.
There she got it. There's... move a little. Boy, that's a sturdy bastard.
You ain't kidding, it is.
What happened?
Chris pumped it down.
I told you. How many times did I tell you?
Back up.
Back up.
Yeah.
I don't know if that one's gonna come out.
It's bending.
It's moving a little.
God, wait till you get it in gear.
Good.
Hold on to your side, Steve. That's the only thing worries me.
What was that?
That was a stump cracking. I don't know, that was a stump cracking. Come on, one more time.
Here comes Chris, watch.
Pardon me?
What happened?
There you go.
You're in the movies there, Ron. At the back of the homestead here. Citation there.
You seen out there with an axe chopping that? Chopping that with an axe. Oh, oh, oh. I sold my stinking chain, so I'm gonna buy me another.
Thank you.
gonna kill Jordan.
Of course. Yeah. That had to hurt. Jordan shot. Oh, wow.
He dug right in, didn't he? He said, oh. Take it easy.
Maybe.
5 minutes.
Yeah, you're in high rate.
Look at you.
You're having fun, are you, Tyler?
And Chris is down there.
What is it, your first day? Yeah, it is.
No, we have it. Hazardous to my health. I wonder how close he thinks he had to get to.
I can feel the air that
good move, Brad. Good move. Excuses, excuses.
Thank you.
Chris.
Hi, Duncan.
Hi,
too. Where's Daddy? Where's Daddy?
Where's
Daddy? We're gonna tip that sucker over here in a minute.
We went to McDonald's.
You went to Donald's? What'd you get, a kazoo?
Spirit of which they are the symbol and endure until the end of time.